टाइप्स ऑफ ट्रेडर्स और टाइप्स ऑफ मार्केट ट्रेड्स आर देयर. द फर्स्ट वन इज वी कैन ऑर्डर इट मार्केट प्राइस, और वी कैन ऑर्डर इट द लिमिट प्राइस, एंड वी कैन ऑर्डर इट स्टॉप लॉस ऑर्डर. स्टॉप लॉस, इन स्टॉप लॉस अगेन देर आर टू टाइप्स. वन इज स्टॉप लॉस लिमिट एंड अदर वन इज स्टॉप लॉस मार्केट. सो द नेक्स्ट कॉन्सेप्ट वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस इज द रिस्क इन्वॉल्व इन डेरिवेटिव ट्रेडिंग. सो इन द बिगिनिंग आई टोल्ड दैट द पर्पस, द मेन पर्पस ऑफ डायरेक्ट कॉन्ट्रैक्ट इज फॉर हेजिंग. हेजिंग मीन्स टू मिनिमाइज द रिस्क इन्वॉल्व इन आवर पोर्टफोलियो. सो वी नो दैट व्हाट आर द वेरियस रिस्क इन्वॉल्व इन द इन्वेस्टमेंट. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, देर विल बी ए मार्केट रिस्क, और देर विल बी इंटरेस्ट रिस्क, और देर विल बी ए लिक्विडिटी रिस्क. सो वेरियस काइंड्स ऑफ रिस्क और काउंटर पार्टी रिस्क ऑल्सो देर. सो वेरियस काइंड्स ऑफ रिस्क आर इन्वॉल्व इन एवरी इन्वेस्टमेंट एवेन्यूज. देर इज नो सच इन्वेस्टमेंट एवेन्यूज आर देर विच इज रिस्क फ्री. ऑफकोर्स देर आर सम इन्वेस्टमेंट एवेन्यूज आर देर वेर वी कैन बेयर ए मिनिमम रिस्क. वी कॉल इट एज ए रिस्क लेस और मिनिमम रिस्क इन्वॉल्व एवेन्यूज. सो देर फोर नॉर्मली द इन्वेस्टर और ट्रेडर दे इन्वॉल्व मच इन्वॉल्व इन इक्विटी शेयर्स. सो दे मेक ट्रेडिंग और दे मेक इन्वेस्टमेंट. सो वेन कॉन्सेप्ट कॉल्ड ट्रेडिंग, ट्रेडिंग इज नॉर्मली वी यूज फॉर डे ट्रेडिंग. डे ट्रेडिंग मीन्स फॉर वन डे ट्रेडिंग. इफ यू परचेज टूडे एंड यू हैव टू सेल इट बाई दी एंड ऑफ द डे ओनली. और इफ यू टेक शॉर्ट पोजिशन एट द मॉर्निंग, एट द इवनिंग यू हैव टू कवर इट. सो दैट इज कॉल्ड नॉट, बेसिकली वी कॉल इट एज ए ट्रेडिंग. ट्रेडिंग इज फॉर वेरी शॉर्ट पीरियड एंड इन्वेस्टमेंट इज फॉर लॉन्ग लॉन्ग पीरियड. सो वेन यू कंपेयर द रिस्क इन्वॉल्व इन द ट्रेडिंग एंड इन्वेस्टमेंट, इन ट्रेडिंग देर इज ए हाई लेवल ऑफ रिस्क बिकॉज वी हैव टू टेक एन प्रॉपर एक्शन विद इन अ शॉर्ट पीरियड. सो देयर फोर द ट्रेडिंग इन्वॉल्व्स हाई लेवल ऑफ रिस्क. सो वेन वी मेक अ ट्रेडिंग इन कैश मार्केट, दैट इज बाई पेइंग फुल कैश एंड परचेजिंग इक्विटी शेयर्स. सो दैट इज कैश मार्केट. सो नॉर्मली वॉट हैपन्स इफ यू इन्वॉल्व इन डे ट्रेडिंग, कंसिडर 100 इक्विटी शेयर्स परचेस्ड. द प्राइस ऑफ 100 इक्विटी शेयर्स इज फॉर एग्जाम्पल 500. सो 100 इंटू 500 लाइक 50,000 अमाउंट यू हैव टू गिव फॉर द परचेज ऑफ दैट शेयर्स. सी व्हाट हैपन्स इन ट्रेडिंग. सी इन ट्रेडिंग नॉर्मली द क्लियरिंग हाउस कॉर्पोरेशन और द ब्रोकर दे विल गिव लिवरेज, दे विल गिव लिवरेज फॉर योर परचेज. लिवरेज और इन नॉर्मल इट्स नॉट राइट टू वर्ड, वी कॉल इट एज अ मार्जिन, बट द राइट वर्ड इज फॉर लिवरेज. लिवरेज मीन्स दे गिव एन एडिशनल अमाउंट टू परचेज दैट कॉन्ट्रैक्ट और टू परचेज इन्वेस्टमेंट. सो वॉट एग्जैक्टली लिवरेज. लिवरेज मीन्स फॉर एग्जाम्पल इन माई ट्रेडिंग अकाउंट आई हैव ओनली 10,000 रुपीज. कंसिडर आई हैव ओनली 10,000 रुपीज, बट आई वॉन्ट टू परचेज 1,000 इक्विटी शेयर्स, नंबर ऑफ 1,000 इक्विटी शेयर्स एंड इट्स मार्केट प्राइस इज 100. कंसिडर द मार्केट प्राइस इज 100. सो बिकॉज आई वॉन्ट ए ह्यूज प्रॉफिट, इफ आई परचेज आई हैव ओनली 10,000. सो विद 10,000 आई कैन परचेज ओनली 100 शेयर्स ऑफ 100 रुपीज. सो आई कैन परचेज ओनली 100 शेयर्स. सो इफ आई मेक, इवन इफ आई मेक 1 2 रुपीज प्रॉफिट, सो 2 रुपीज for one share, that means 100 into 2, 200, the profit is very minimum in case of cash market buying, that is especially in investment. If I purchase the number of shares with amount I have in my trading account, so only 100 shares I can purchase with the 10,000, the profit also minimum. So here what happens, some of the broker, they give leverage. Some broker, they give 10 times you can purchase. Some brokers will give 15 times. So how it works? See, I have 10,000. So if broker gives 10 times leverage, so that means 10,000 into 10, so 1 lakh. So it amount 1 lakh. So that means I can purchase up to 1 lakh worth of investment. Here, my amount is only 10,000, but broker will give you 10 times leverage. 10 times leverage. So I can purchase 1 lakh amount of investment. See what happens. So when they give additional 80,000 as leverage, so I can purchase more number of shares, or I can purchase more number of contract. See, if I purchase more number of shares, the magnitude of profit also increase. It's similar to the leverage, 10 times. Consider two example, two separate setup example. In one case you are purchasing the number of shares with your amount only with 10,000. So with 10,000 I can purchase 100 shares. I'll try it right here. So consider two circumstance. One, I am going to purchase number of equity shares with amount available in my, so two case. So this is, I'm purchasing whatever amount with my demat account or trading account, and this is with the help of leverage. This is with the help of cash only. This is with the help of leverage. So consider the market price of the share is 100 rupees in both the cases. Same, one stock, ABC Limited. The stock price of ABC Limited is 100 rupees. So here, broker is giving 10 times leverage. So I can buy 10, whatever amount I have in my demat account. For example, in my demat account I have cash of 10,000. From my savings account I transfer 10,000 to my demat account. So in my demat account I have 10,000. So what happens if I use 10,000 for cash purchase, and with the 10,000 if I use leverage and purchase shares? See here, if I use the cash of 10,000 for 100 rupees market price, so I can purchase the number of shares is 100. So this is the market price, this is 100 market price, and this is the number of shares. So number of shares 100 in case of cash purchase, 100 into 100, so 10,000. Done. Now check out what is the profit or loss. If so, I purchase for 100 rupees, and consider if the market price increase 100 to 1 or 2. So this is the current market price. Current market price 1 or 2. Here also, current market price 1 or 2. Okay. Now, calculate what is the profit purchased at 100 and now selling it 102. So 2 rupees profit per shares. So total number of shares purchased 100. So 100 into 2. So the profit is 200. Profit is 200. And here, if I use second case, if I use leverage given by the broker, so I can purchase 10 times. The leverage is given by the broker is 10 times. So I have 10,000. So 10,000 into 10, 10,000 into 10, so 1 lakh. So I can purchase up to 1 lakh amount of shares. Correct? So I can purchase up to 1 lakh amount of shares. So how many shares I can purchase? So 1 lakh divided by 100, 1 lakh divided by 100. So that is 1000. So I can purchase 1000 number of shares. Now consider the profit. So 2 per shares, so 2 into 1000. So 2000 is the profit. See the benefit of leverage. You invested only 10,000. In both the case, you invested only 10,000. From your bank account, you transferred only 10,000. See the profit difference. If you do not use leverage, you get profit of 200. If you use leverage, then you can make profit of 2000. See the difference. Difference is 1800. 1800 is the additional profit if you use leverage. So this is the benefit of the leverage and which attract more number of trader into trading. Of course, this is one side. If the market goes favorable for the trader, then he can make profit. What happens if the market goes other direction? Like consider in this case, he purchased at 80, 100. If the market price fall to rupees 80, then consider a loss. Calculate the loss in both the case. Here, so 20 rupees per share, so 20 into 100, so 2000, correct? Yeah, sorry. 20 into 100, so 2000 in case of cash. And here, 20 into 1000, 1000 number of shares, so the profit, sorry, the loss amount is 20,000. Not only the profit, the magnitude of profit is high, but also the magnitude of the loss also high in case of leverage. So the loss is 20,000. So that means your investment is 10,000. So you not only you entirely lose your principal amount, but also you have to additionally you have to make the investment that to cover the loss 10,000. So this is a main risk involved in trading. This is the main risk involved in trading that the leverage, using of leverage. So here, what is the risk involved in derivative trading? As I said, derivative can be used for hedging purpose. But nowadays, due to its wide availability, most of the trader they use for speculative purpose. They use for speculative purpose. That means to make a huge profit, what they do? They purchase it for short period. They buy at low and try to sell at high, or they take short position at high price and try to cover at a lower price. So if the market goes the favorable situation, they can make profit. Otherwise, they make huge loss. So that is the biggest limitations of trading, and which is associated with the derivative trading also. And next one, so there are three important types of derived contract we discussed. That is forward contract and option contract and future contract. So the main risk involved in a forward contract is a counterparty risk. Counterparty risk means as a forward contract is not taken place in over the counter, sorry, has not taken place in stock market, there is no regulatory body for forward contract. So there is high chance of counterparty risk. That means one party, any one party may breach the contract. See, normally what happens, normally a human being, he exercises the contract only when that contract is profitable for him. Otherwise, he will try to breach the contract. So if there is no legal backup, of course anyone can breach the contract. So that is the biggest risk involved in forward contract. So the forward contract is not standardized, and there is no government support, or there is no government backup. So there is a high chance of breach of contract. So especially that forward contract is normally for day, but it is a contract for day-to-day life. So there is no official letter, or there is no official what memorandum for that particular contract. And the next one, next types of derived contract is the option contract. So what are the risk involved in option contract? So the main, as we discussed, how option contract is taken place. So in option contract, there will be two parties. One is buyer and seller. The person who purchases the option contract, we call it as a buyer. So he has to make margin amount. He has to pay margin amount to buy the option contract. The whoever purchases the option contract, he'll get right to execute the contract. If he purchases a call option, then he get right to purchase underlying asset. And if he purchase a put option, then he get a right to sell underlying asset. So, and here the term is, he can exercise the contract on or before expiry date. There will be a maturity date or expiry date. So for example, if it is 1 month contract, on the end of the month, so there will be exercise, or there will be maturity date. On that date, they has to execute or exercise the contract. In option contract, we call it as expiry day. So on or before that expiry day, one has to exercise his contract, because after expiry date, that option contract will become worthless. Consider today the date is 9th July 2021. So if I purchase one option contract by giving 30 rupees for one share, 30 into 100, consider lot size is 100. So 30 into 100, so 3000. A 3000 amount have to pay to purchase that particular option. So today is the 7th. Today date is 9th July 2021. The expiry date for that particular contract is 3rd Thursday, yes, 3rd Thursday of that month. For example, in this month, that is July, 3rd Thursday is on 29. So 29 July 2021 is the expiry for that particular contract. So that means on or before 29th July 2021, I have to exercise the contract. Otherwise, after 29th, the value of that option contract is zero. So whatever I invested, that is 3000 amount, will become zero. So there is a high chance, so an investor may lose his entire investment. If I invested 30,000 to purchase option, if I do not exercise on before the expiry date, my investment amount will be zero. So that is the risk involved in option contract. So it becomes worthless when it expires. So there is high pressure for investor. They have to exercise before before it get zero. So there is, and sometimes we need to book our loss because on the last date the option price, the premium amount will be zero. And here, yeah, and one more risk is if the market price is moved as I expected, then I can make profit. Consider current market price of one stock is 100 and I expect that in future it will go up to 150. So therefore I purchase call option. So if market reaches 150, then I make the profit. What is the profit? 100 minus 150. So that is the 50 into number of shares, and along minus the premium amount I paid for to purchase that option contract. So that is the net profit. So what happens if market goes other direction? That means I expect it will increase, but if it falls, so I make loss along with premium amount. So that is the second risk involved in option contract. And also the risk or the loss of option contract is depend upon the extent to which holder utilize the leverage. So here they give leverage 10 times or 15 times. Even in crypto market, they will give 200%, 150%, like that. But there is no compulsory that you have to use those leverages. So sometimes the holder or investor, he use up to 50%. So that is okay. But sometimes the investor or trader utilize the entire leverage. So that is which attracts high risk. And of course, if it is most favorable to your market direction, your market price, then you can make profit. So, and next, what a investor can do to mitigate or to dilute that risk involved in his portfolio? So we call it as hedging. How we can hedge our risk involved in portfolio. See, the investor dilute the risk if we invest part of the money in buying option and the remaining amount of some riskless securities. So when you purchase, when you make like that, the beta of entire portfolio will be reduced. The beta, consider in this example, the beta is nothing but the sensitivity of individual stock on market. If market, how we interpret, for example, beta of ACC Limited is 0.98. 0.98 means if market moves 1%, the ACC, the market price of ACC Limited moves 0.98, which is similar to correlation coefficient. We interpret correlation coefficient like that. Beta is nothing but sensitivity of individual stock on market price or market index like Sensex or Nifty. Here, buying an option and remaining riskless securities, because the beta of riskless is very low, very less. So even if the market falls, the risk on treasury bills or government securities very low. So in your portfolio, you should not invest entire your money on one stock or one type of stocks. So it is always better to go with the diversified portfolio. Invest in option, invest in cash market, investment in some money market instrument also is important to manage the risk. Okay. So it is, we have to see, it is, we have to see that whether the option is out of the money or in the money. See, normally what happens when the expiry date is closer, normally the option contract will be out of the money. And if the expiry date is long, then normally there will be in the money for the option. In the money means the expiry date, sorry, expiry price or strike price. Strike price is more than the market price. And out of the money means strike price is less than the market price. Okay. And one more risk involved in option contract is, so there will be normally two types of, we discussed two types of options are there. One is American style option and European style option. So difference between American style option is exercisable at any time of the expiration date. Consider previous example. I purchased option on 9/7/2021. The expiry date is 29/7/2021. So on or before 29/7/2020, I can exercise, or on the date on 29/7/2000, I can exercise. So there is two options in under American style of option, but under European style of option, you can exercise only on the date of expiration. That is on 29/7/2021. You cannot exercise before expiration, but if you purchase European style of option, what you can do, if for example on the 15/7/2021, I got favorable market price, means I'm making profit on 15/7/2021. So I want to sell my option contract. If I purchased American option, then I can exercise. But if I purchased European style of option, I cannot exercise because it can be exercised only on the date of expiration. And what I can do? See, here I can do, if I can sell it in a secondary market by taking an opposite position. See, if I purchase there, if I took a long position, then I have to take here a short position. So that is the only way we can exit from the contract under European style of option. But there is one risk. What is that risk? If in a secondary market, if there is no option is available during that time, then you cannot exercise the contract. You know that there should be enough number of buyer and seller to exercise the contract. So I am ready to sell 100 shares at 90, but there is no buyer on the other hand, then my contract will not be exercised. So there is, it happens sometimes, there will be no buyer or there will be no seller. So in such case, your European style of option cannot be exercised. And you have to take in American style or European style, any option. You have to check every day what is the profitable situation. So if you make profit, then you have to exercise the contract under American style of option. So in addition to all this, there are some legal issues are there. Like sometimes various regulatory and legal authorities may impose trading or exercise restrictions in certain circumstances. So they impose some of the restriction. Example, see, sometime what happens, we call downward freezing. If any news came out, if you may know that in the last 2 weeks for Adani stocks, so there are some issues involved with Adani shares or the Adani companies. So at that time, every day there was a downward freezing. At that time, if market price of any particular stock falls 5%, below 5%, then the stock market, they freeze. They will withstand the buyer and seller. They will put restriction to buyer and seller for trading because they do not allow to investor to execute the contract on that day. Beyond 5%, if the market price falls beyond 5%, they put restriction on the trading. They halt for the days. So it happens. It happens many times. So recent I said for Adani stock also it happens. So that is the legal issues involved in derived contract trading. And yeah, here in option contract also there will be two parties. One is a writer who writes the contract, and other one is the buyer who invests the contract. So for writer, if he takes a covered call option, so there are certain risk involved. And if we take uncovered call options, so what is covered call option? Covered call option means with having underlying asset, you are writing option. Means I have 100 shares of ACC Limited, then I can write call option or put option of ACC Limited. So I have in my demat account, that is stocks or underlying asset. So that is called covered call option. Uncovered or naked call option means here the writer of the option do not hold the underlying asset. Without holding underlying asset, he can write the option, and that type of option is called uncovered call option. So what is the risk involved in covered call option for the writer? See, here one example is given. Suppose a call option is written on the shares with an exercise price matching with its current market price 70. So he one person write call option for rupees 70, one stock which he hold in his demat account. He already purchased that particular stock for cash, and now he is writing an option of rupees 70. And the premium for that is 5. 5 rupees is a premium. And now assume that the price of the shares increased to 82. If the market price increased to 82, then he make in his cash market, he makes the profit of 70 minus 82. So that is the profit. As a consequence, he receives 7,000 for the shares in addition to the premium 5 rupees. 5 into, for example, he purchased 100. So 100 into 77,000, and premium amount is 5 into 100. That is the profit for the writer. And but if market goes other round, then he makes the loss, but he receives the premium amount. So that is the risk involved in writing option with holding stock. If a person do not have underlying asset and writing call option, then what happens? So if the market goes favorable situation, then he makes a profit. If the market goes with unfavorable situation, then he has to purchase that underlying asset if it is physical delivery. Especially in case of physical delivery, that means for example, I entered into contract of to purchase 100 ounce of gold, 100 ounce of gold. For example, I'm the writer of call option. So I have to sell underlying asset. I do not have, for example, right now I do not have 100 ounce of gold. But on the maturity date, if the market goes unfavorable, then if buyer demands physical delivery, then has to give 100 ounce of gold to the buyer. So that is the main risk involved in uncovered call option. And Yeah, his obligation on the call, losing an amount equal to the excess of the purchase price over the exercise price of the call, reduced by the amount received. Yeah, here he has to purchase underlying asset and give it to deliver it to the buyer. So that is the loss, and that should be deducted by the premium amount he received while writing the call option. And in uncovered call writing also involves larger margin requirements, which may rise substantially. The market moves in adverse direction. Who writes the option, uncovered option? He has to maintain a larger margin amount to write that particular option. And sometime a investor or trader, they involved in multiple transaction, buying and writing multiple option. Buying a call option and buying a put option at the same time, or buying a call option of different stocks, or buying call option and selling put option. So these are called multiple transactions. So they are with the expectation of making profit or with the expectation of hedging risk. They involved in a number of transaction. We call it as a multiple transaction. So sometimes what happens, it is very difficult to execute those transaction at a simultaneously. Sometimes the trader forgot about how many contract they have, or sometimes you know that the market price of stocks, it moves quickly. When you are exercising one contract, at that time the other contract may fall. So there are high chance, due to high volatility in the market, it is very impossible to execute the transaction simultaneously. And the options of different styles, while purchasing call option and purchasing put option, purchasing American option and purchasing European style of option, because the American option can be exercised at any time, but European style option can be exercised only on the date of execution of the contract or maturity date. So in addition to this possibility of installing brokerage firm, so this is the some you heard about some of these scams or scandals. So, in addition to all those risks, there is a possibility of insolvency of brokerage. So, if the brokerage firm goes insolvency, so bankruptcy, then whatever amount you hand over to your brokers, so you may lose that. So, there is a high chance you are lose your money due to insolvency of brokerage, and even sometime clearing house corporation. There are many stock markets which closed after insolvency. And sometimes the trader lose his money due to a technical problems, technical software problems, website problems. See, fail or a failure of its backup. There will be sometime there will be no backup. It happens many times. So there is one example is given, the failure of InSAT 2D in October 1997. So sometimes for maintenance purpose, they hold their services. So at that time, many investors lose their amount. So due to technical problem also, investor lose their money. And what are the risks involved in a future contract? So when compared to forward contract, there will be, of course, there will be no counterparty risk. But and here one biggest advantage is by giving margin amount, you can purchase that contract instead of going to cash market. Here I give just a margin amount. So that benefits, which attract more number of traders and which involve them greed or fear, may lead to reckless trading. Because for 1 lakh amount of with the 10,000, they can purchase 1 lakh amount of stocks. So sometimes they involve number of trading in a one day, and the buying and selling recklessly. So it is a disaster of trading. So there is one case studies there, that is Barings Bank case study. So if you are interested, you can read about that Barings Bank. Nick Leeson is the person who behind of Barings Bank scams. You can read about that. So yeah, possibility of manipulation, fraud, and abuse to ex also exist, particularly when the future contract relates to individual stocks, since individual scripts may be driven up or drawn down to make killing on the future and option contracts. So this is normally happens when the institutional investors, we call it a big investor. So whenever they want to manipulate the price, so sometimes they large number of shares buying or the large number of shares selling to manipulate the market, or sometimes spreading rumors about the market. You can see that there are Elon Musk, his tweet, how his tweet is impact on the investment, particularly in crypto market. Whenever he tweet about crypto market, the market moves like up and down. So if he tweet positively about crypto, then the market goes up. So that one person, there is high chance such person they manipulate the market price whenever they want to do. So that is the risk involved in future contract. And here in future contract, what happens? Consider the futures of Adani stocks, future contract of Adani, and there will be stock of Adani in cash market. The person who wants to reduce the premium amount of future contract, what he can do? He manipulate. Manipulate means he can either going for rigging or something. He manipulates the market price of Adani stocks in cash market by spreading the rumors. So whenever the cash market price falls, so it adversely affect the price of the future contract. Yeah. So therefore, it is always suggested to go for index-based futures, because index is basically on the market, overall the market. So there is no one individual stock involved in index-based futures. So index-based future is very less involved in manipulation. So to manipulate index, you have to manipulate the entire market. So it is impossible to manipulate the entire market. So one can manipulate one stock, one company, but it is very difficult to manipulate the entire market. So these are the risks involved in a derivative contract. So there will be one case studies there. So if you are interested, you can read this one, the Barings Saga, Nick Leeson case study, which is very interesting case. So about derivative contract, how he collapsed the financial Barings Bank. So you can read. I shared the material already. Yes. Now, if you have any doubt, you can ask. Any doubt, students?
No, sir.
Okay. Thank you.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.